Thirsty on the east side of town? Well, head to a WNST favorite. King Discount Liquors on Pulaski Highway, just inside the Beltway. They have it all.
I'm Johnny Bev down at King Liquors. Come and see me for all your needs in wine, spirits, and beer.
Don't forget to give the King a ring.
Today. Adam Schefter's here. Have you ever done 8 hours on NFL Network?
Yeah, actually, the first and second day of the NFL draft, where you stand there literally from, say, what is it, 10 in the morning, noon it starts, but we're in position at 11, and we went to midnight, and I remember at one point, I had to go to the bathroom so bad, I felt my bladder was going to burst, and I was going to be rushed to the hospital with poisoning inside.
So you know what we're going through. Except, see,
I know what you're going through.
The difference is, you have to look good for 8 hours. We can come in like we look.
That's a hard thing to do. You know, when I get to shave every hour. That's the problem that I have.
Right.
They call me Teen Wolf.
Right. Adam, pretty cool for you and the rest of the guys involved with the NFL Network to be in on what could be historically something we'll never see again in our lifetime with this Patriots 19-0.
So we're going to see history one way or another.
Right.
Okay, we're going to see the Patriots win the game and go to 19-0. We're going to see one of the great upsets in Super Bowl history, a game that you'll always remember because the Patriots were dethroned before they could ever get to 19-0 when the Giants won basically their 11th straight road
game. And Plaxico was right.
23-17. I mean, I know it doesn't mean a whole lot in the grand scheme of things, but I just want to see the New England Patriots play a team without the other team providing the Patriots with a single bit of ammunition to put up on their bulletin. Why do they do this?
Well, it seems like every team thinks they're going to be that team.
They do. You know, and I'm going to tell you something. I remember I was out at NFL Network in LA in October, the week after the Patriots beat the Bengals, and TJ Houshmandzadeh was on set. He and I were talking. He goes, Adam, they're not that good. They're going down. Okay? They're going to get beat. They're overrated. Well, I'm still waiting.
It's January 30th today.
Right? It hasn't happened yet.
Hey, I've talked about this with a lot of people that have come in, the media people that have come in. If you were going to write the story, or in your case, if you're going to stand up on Sunday night and do the ultimate Adam Schefter story, is it the 19-0, or is it Tom Coughlin 3 weeks into the season looking like he might be getting bounced out, Giants starting off 0-2, about to be 0-3, and coming back and winning these 10 in a row on the road?
You know, the Giants are a great story. Great, great story. I mean, it's tremendous what they've done. All the things you said, you're absolutely right on. But they used to have a thing on NFL Network on Friday and Saturday. Okay, what's the one thing you're looking forward to seeing this weekend? And I said, about week 5 or week 6, I said, until the Patriots lose a game.
That's the story.
That's the story. The end. I mean, until they lose, that's it. They are the biggest deal going around. And that, to me, is one of the reasons that so many people have tuned into their games this year, why the ratings have been through the roof, why the ratings for Sunday's game will be through the roof, why they've become the villain. They've become the team that everybody loves to hate. And I would say that outside of New England, the New England area, there are very few people rooting for the Patriots to win that game. I think the Giants have a heavy following on Sunday night. And I think a lot of people would love to see the Giants win. I don't think it'll happen, but I think a lot of people would love to see it.